James Pflueger's early release from jail last week brought up concerns about special treatment. Tonight, we're learning more about the decision behind his release. On Friday, after serving only a month behind bars, the 89-year-old Pflueger was released from the Kauai Community Correctional Facility due to medical reasons. He will serve the rest of his sentence at home. Pflueger was sentenced to 7 months in prison for the deadly Koloko Dam breach that killed seven people in 2006. We wanted to know, how often does the state grant medical releases? And is there a chance Pflueger could go back to jail? Brent Romodna got some answers. Brent?
Joe, I sat down with Public Safety Director Ted Sakai because there were still a lot of questions surrounding Pflueger's release.
And, you know, many people will not agree with the decision.
A difficult decision, according to Director of Public Safety Ted Sakai, but one he said he had to make.
But again, you know, I just hope they look at all of the things I had to consider.
That decision allowing James Pflueger to serve the rest of his 7 month sentence at home because of a medical condition.
You know, our intent was, you know, we're going to honor the sentence. And that's what we were doing until I was told by our doctors that there had been some, based on their observations and their examination of him, they had some serious concerns about him.
Facility doctors make the recommendation based on an inmate's medical status. In this case, Sakai says KCCC could not offer Pflueger appropriate care. We wanted to know if these medical releases are common. Sakai says he grants about 10 each year, and to get a medical release, he has to consider the inmate's risk to the public and what type of care the inmate will receive outside of the facility. So how strict are the guidelines for Pflueger's release?
Can family visit him at any time, or can he have visitors, or does he have special guidelines while at home?
No, he can have visitors at his home.
Serving a sentence with all the amenities of home. As for the people who lost loved ones in the Koloko Dam breach, Sakai explains why they weren't told of Pflueger's release.
My understanding was there was no legal requirement that we do so, but it was the right thing to do, so I asked the AG to do the notification, and somehow it fell between the cracks. So, but we definitely wanted the victims notified ahead of time.
Was there any special treatment in this case or anything looked at differently?
No, we looked at this case just as we would look at any other case.
Now, Sakai did tell me that if Pflueger's health improved, he would be sent back to jail to serve out his time. We'll let you know if that happens. Brent Romodnik, KHON 2 News.